Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. It's time now for one of our favorite segments. It's called Full Circle, where we dive deeper into controversial and current topics. Mm-hmm. The topic on the table today is letting go, and we decided to keep Keri Hilson around for this one.
I know how to do that.
Yes, okay. Yes. But before we get into that, I know, Ms. Quad, you had something for Ms. Keri as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, I absolutely do. I mean, you've done some amazing things in music. I just got to know, what's going on with you musically? What are you doing?
I've been writing. Good. I never stopped writing.
Okay, good.
Just for others. Mm-hmm. Some for myself. I pulled some records, you know, that was supposed to be for somebody else. I'm like, I'm going to tuck this away from me. I continued writing for others. And as far as my artistry, I'm sure people really want to know that as well. I'm just handling some business. I pride myself in doing good business and making good decisions.
Yes.
For life situations such as mine,
yes.
Where if you need to take a hiatus, you can't.
Yes,
somebody.
Yes.
So I'm just handling that before I can release anything.
Okay, good. That makes a
whole
lot of sense.
But until then, I'm so fulfilled writing.
Good. We love you for that. Okay, so each one of us chose some lyrics from one of Keri's hits.
Yes.
And we'll apply the lyrics to a time in our life when we had to let go.
Okay.
So we're going to break the ice with you, Keri.
Okay.
In your experience, what's been
the
difference between...
Yeah.
Hey.
That's one of the songs I wrote for Britney.
Yes. What's been your experience between letting go in anger and letting go in love?
What's been the difference?
Letting go in anger, when you mad and you let go,
or letting go in love.
Like, it's
I have done both. It's definitely better to let go in love and light.
Mm-hmm.
It is.
And to express that.
Yes.
I love you, I forgive you, but I can't be with you.
Right. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I've done
both. Yeah.
And that anger, you know, it's so lingering.
Yeah.
It's so, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not an angry person. I'm just by nature, I get over things pretty quickly, but I also know how I want to live,
right.
And I know what I deserve,
right.
And I don't choose decisions that make my life harder.
That's right. Just
really
simple. Yeah.
And in those relationships, whether the one you let go in love or the one you let go in kind of being angry,
right.
Did you see the difference of the outcomes with the individuals and your relationships with the individuals?
With them?
Yeah.
I don't really care.
Right.
So you don't
it was all
say,
about
hey, be friendly.
The difference that I felt.
Right.
Mm. Yes.
It's more about that because
you
didn't spare my feelings when you did.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? So
hello, somebody.
I'm not going to spare your feelings.
Right. Yep.
I'm just going to move on and do what feels better to me, and it felt better to let go and love.
Right.
All right.
I wish you all the love and light.
But I gotta go.
So here's one of my favorite songs. I think I always say this every time I see you. My favorite song is Beautiful Mistake. Yes, it is what it is.
It is.
Damn, I wish I could stay. We were a beautiful mistake. Boy, you know I'm gonna miss you by my side. But it is what it is. You're giving up all that. I know
Come
that
on,
whole
thing.
Right. So yeah, this was a situation
Album
in my
cut.
Life.
Come on.
I love that. I thought that should have been a single. But you know, who am I? So yeah, this was a situation in my life. I had my college boyfriend. You know, we were together for a long time,
mm-hmm.
the whole 4 years. Mm. But then that senior year, I just wanted to...
What did you do? Did you cheat?
Yeah, what happened?
It was a beautiful mistake.
What's up? I'm turning up in your former life.
It is what it is.
You're allowed to make mistakes in your early 20s. Now, when you get to 27, 28, 29, 30, things should have been corrected. I think it's some of the best lovers have seen both sides of the coin.
Yes.
They have hurt someone and they have been hurt.
Oh, yes. I did hurt him. We were together for a very long time. I hurt him. I did. He wanted to be married.
You be turning up.
I'm turning up.
I got when you're young.
But that
life,
marriage is scary that young.
Yes.
Yeah. I
would recommend
there.
That.
You just feel like, ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh, well.
Yeah, what do you have?
Mine knocked you down in 2009. Ooh, 2009 is a good year for me. I actually walked away from my ex of 10 years at that time.
That made it a good year.
That made it a good year. Because, girl, I was like, I got to go. So here it is. It says, say you got to take the good, the bad, the happy, and the sad. But when you bring a better future than I had in the past, because I don't want to make the same mistake and I did. I don't want to fall back on my face again.
Oh, that's good.
Amen.
Come on, lyrics.
Come on now. We've been through,
but
huh?
Will you bring a better... I'm just correcting that. Will you bring a better future than I had in the past?
Ooh, that's good. That's a good question to ask a man.
That's a good old,
especially,
a new man.
Yeah. Especially if you're considering dating them.
Yeah. You're just going to lie. They're all going to say yes.
Yeah, they're going to lie because they're going to say, well, he don't know what he compares
Guys, let's put the good energy out there.
What do the whites of his eyes look like, though, when you're saying
they look like lies. Selena, they look like lies.
You can tell that the lies is on.
Some of them are really good, though. Yeah. That face value, like, they have it down.
Yes.
For a very, very, very long time.
But his actions will show. Real yes. quickly, the man. Yeah, he exposes
I've learned. Yeah, definitely. Always look at the action.
Yes. Well, see, I'm an energy girl, mm-hmm. which brings me to energy. My to the next quote.
Okay,
because that's my jam.
Yeah,
okay.
Energy.
Energy. energy. Now, this is what I had. What you had to say about the energy?
No, you know, lean all the way back.
Say, I wish I could rip out a page of my memory, because I put too much energy in him and me. Can't wait till I get through this phase, because it's killing me. Too bad we can't rewrite our own history.
Ooh.
Yeah.
You said that.
Yeah. My God.
Look at Keri's face. She's like, wait, no.
That's everybody. Yeah. My past. Mm-hmm. Everybody. Mm-hmm. I wish I could rip off that page of my memory. Basically, I mean, there were a lot of relationships that I've been in. I mean, I was married once before and divorced, and now I'm married again. But there have been a lot of relationships that I've had that I'd be like, man, I wish I could just take that piece of it out or whatever.
Yeah.
But as I've gotten older, I realize I need all of those pages.
Mm-hmm.
And I needed all of that memory so that I can make sound choices and decisions now.
Yeah. And be the woman you are.
And have found the husband that I have now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So actually, but energy, though, I must say, this song in general, and I don't think anyone's ever written a record quite like this with this perspective. Mm. Energy is very important in relationships.
Yes.
And I think that that's the tie that kind of brought me and my husband together.
Yes. It's got to be an even flow.
Yes. Well, I'm going to go ahead and jump in here really quickly. This was from Breaking Point 2010. Mm. Keri goes on to say in her song, because some women just tolerate too damn much.
Mm.
Now, I got to, now I know we got to just choose our battles, right? But damn it, every woman got a breaking point, bro.
Hello, somebody.
Yes. My God. She says, also, next time you see him, next time he's testing you, your love, say to him, my love has a limit.
Yes.
My love has a limit. Yes. And listen, that is so important because I think a lot of times with women, we really give and give and give and give. And we give, I mean, almost unconditionally. Mm-hmm. I can also say even in my marriage, there were many times where I was really, really hurt and deeply in pain. And I would continue to still give and give and give to the point where it just seemed like it was never enough.
Right,
you know, it was too, you know, I had even asked myself, well, where is the reciprocity for me?
Right, right.
And it never seemed that it was there on an emotional note. And I just found myself constantly getting hurt to the point I had to just say, listen, Miss Squad Girl, it's okay to have a limit. Mm-hmm. It's okay to let it go.
Yes.
You know, and I finally got to that point, Keri, and I did. And recently I filed for divorce.
Yeah. I'm so sorry to hear what you're going through, but I'm happy that you're making a decision for you to protect yourself.
Yes.
You know, because those boundaries and limits, they are our guides.
Yeah.
We feel when we're left of center. We feel when we're right of center. You know what I mean? We know it, and we allow ourselves to go so long. And,
yes, we do.
You know, in the name of unconditional love,
right.
But I'm sorry, there are conditions
yes.
to how I expect to be treated and how I will not be treated, you know.
Yeah.
So
this was
there are limits.
She said it was teachable Thursday.
Yes, it is. And I always say I love me more than I would ever love him.
Anyone else?
And
yes.
You, man, you have to make that decision.
Yeah.
Well, you gotta love God more than anything.
Come on
first.
Now.
Yes. True. I always say I belong to God before I belong to anyone else.
Hello, yeah. About that. Yeah. When you love him, you can love everything.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, Keri, thank you.
Yes.
It's always a pleasure.
Yes.
My Decatur sister right here.
Please.
Yes. Don't get up yet. We gotta tease out.
Right.
Congratulations again on your Spirit of the City
Champion
Award. We love to hear about your let go moment, and please send us your thoughts at all of our social platforms, Sister Circle TV.
Yeah.